Hello, Asa here, and welcome back or welcome to my channel. Today I'm back with another little educational video, and this time it's all about makeup product placement using cream makeup products and powder makeup products. So before we start, make sure you apply your foundation first, apply your concealer, and if you are planning to use a cream or liquid product, leave the face not set with any powder, just leave it tacky. So your liquid products, in other words, should go on straight onto the foundation, which is not set with anything. On the other hand, if you're using powder products to contour and blusher and highlighter, make sure to set your foundation slightly with powder. So first, let's start with a liquid product placement, and more specifically with bronzing or contouring. So no matter what product you're using, whether it's a cream bronzer or contouring, if it's liquid contour or bronzing, or if it's a stick contour or bronzer, the placement is pretty much the same. So the difference between contouring and bronzing is that the contour product is always a little bit cooler in color, and it's meant to add shadows and depth to your face. Bronzing products, they are more warmer, so they're meant to give you warmth to your face and that sun-kissed look. So how to contour? Make sure you'll find your cheekbone. So the easiest way is to suck your cheeks in, and it should become more prominent so you know where to apply the product. It's literally just underneath that cheekbone. Or if your cheekbones are not showing, you can follow this line from the top of the ear towards your nose, but make sure that you stop where your eye starts. So this should be the lowest point for your contour or bronzing. I'll start with the contour. So my cheekbone is literally here. So I'm just applying few dots of that product just underneath my cheekbone. If I were to use a bronzer stick or bronzing cream, I would apply it into the same area, or if I would like to get that a bit lifted effect, I would apply it a little bit higher up on the cheekbone. So for blending your contour or bronzer, you can use a more dense brush. This one is from Real Techniques and it's a sculpting brush. This is literally what it's meant for. And start by dabbing the product in. Don't try to swipe or anything, just dab it in. So it'll be easier than to blend it out, and you will keep it in this more specific area that you want your product. So by dabbing, you see how easily that blends out. Always make sure to go into your hairline a little bit so it doesn't look like it's sitting out of nowhere. As you can see, I'm stopping at this point here. It means that my eye starts here. So this is the lowest point of my bronzer or contour. I'm not going anywhere lower because it would drag my face down. Also, instead of a brush, if you are a fan of beauty blenders, you can blend it out using a sponge as well. Contour or bronze side of your forehead. If you have larger forehead, you can contour top of your forehead if you have very long face. So just depending on your face shape. Now let's move on and do our powder bronzing. As I said before, you want to set your face in the areas that you're going to apply your bronzer, because if you leave it tacky, your bronzer might cling to your skin too much or look patchy. So just to avoid that unnecessary work that you might need to do fixing this problem, just set it slightly with translucent or pressed powder so you get rid of that tackiness and it's nice and dry. So now we will apply a dry product on a dry base, and on this side we applied liquid product on a liquid base. There's also exceptions and I'll talk about these later, but for now, once you have this tackiness removed, then you can proceed and apply your bronzer. So for applying a powder bronzer, you pretty much need maybe just one brush. So I would suggest just an angled brush, because you can use it for your bronzer as well as for your blush. So it's like two in one, and it's great because you don't need that many tools then. Many brands are doing angled brushes. This is from Sigma, but I know that Rebeluna has one, Zoeva has one, also Nima brushes. So literally anywhere you see this kind of angled side of a brush, this is the one to use for your contouring, bronzing, or for your blusher. So for the powder bronzing, we're going to work not with the belly of the brush, but with the side of a brush, because we want to keep our bronzer kind of nice and high and make sure to avoid dragging our face down. So what I mean by this is we're going to dip the brush into the product at the angle, as you can see, like this, and always make sure to tap the excess off so there's not too much of the product going onto your face straight away. And the placement is exactly the same as with liquid products. So just follow your cheekbone line or from the top of the ear towards your nose, but stop where your eye starts. So what you want to do, you want to apply your bronzer in the upward motion. So imagine that doing little circles in upward motion. And if I want that lifted effect again, I can apply a little bit onto my cheekbone. So it kind of looks nice and sun-kissed. Obviously, you can apply some product on the side of your forehead or on top of your forehead, depending on your face shape. So just like that, we have a powder bronzer and then liquid bronzer and liquid contour done. With the powders, if it's a bronzer, you can be not as specific because it's something you want to bring warmth to your face. Whereas if you're using contour, make sure to apply it underneath your cheekbone. But if you're using something nice and warm like this bronzing stick, you can just use it in the same area that you would use your powder bronzer. So next up is a blush. The blusher is actually an exception. So many liquid and cream blushers can definitely go on the powdery surface, but for those, you have to be careful to really gently blend it, maybe with your fingers or a sponge, so not to disturb the powder and foundation underneath. But normally, if you want, you can just use it straight on a tacky foundation base, and this is what I'm gonna do now. So again, it doesn't matter what type of blusher you're using, if it's like a cream blusher or if it's a liquid blusher, the placement would be always kind of the same as well. So make sure you don't apply your blusher too close to your nose and too high to your eye. Literally, if you can use two fingers and apply it higher up on your cheek, I think this is the most flattering place as well. And you can blend this cream or liquid blusher using your fingers by dabbing that on. So the warmth of your fingers would really melt the product into your skin. Or you can use the same brush that you applied your contour with. Make sure to clean the excess bronzer if there's any left in the tissue, and you can just dab that on. Again, always dab, don't try to swipe because you will move the whole base. Just like that, we dabbing, and when there's literally nothing left to dab, you can go and dab it towards that contour or bronzer that you applied. So one product melts into another and it doesn't look like one sits here and the other sits underneath. You can also use a sponge to blend it out, or as I said, you can use a brush. I love to apply my cream blushers with my fingers. I think the fingers work best by blending everything out. So literally just dabbing it with my ring finger on the top of the cheekbones and then towards my contour. So on the powder side, same placement applies. You can use the same brush, as I said, the angle brush. You can slightly clean it off in the tissue or at the back of your hand so there's no bronzer left. Now we're going to work with the actual belly of the brush. So we want to pick the product on the belly, and we're just kind of dipping it into the product. As always with the powders, make sure to tap out the excess, and same placement, not too close to your nose, but not too close to your eyes. You can start dabbing this blusher on. So you can repeat the same step a few times, depending on how intense you want your blush. So you want to dab that on first if you want, and then once you dabbed it on, you can use a slight circular motions if you feel that it's more comfortable for you to do that instead of dabbing. So, and just like that, we have our blusher on. As you can see, this blusher that I applied have a slight golden particles in it, so it looks like it's a highlighter all together with the blush, whereas on this side is more kind of wet looking and more dewy looking. So the last stop is the highlighter. So highlighters again come in liquid form and cream form, so doesn't matter whichever you like, the placement again is always kind of the same. So what you want to do, you want to find the highest point of your cheekbone. And also sometimes when you look in the mirror, you can naturally see where the light kind of bounces off. For me, it's here, so it means this is where I should apply my highlighter. And I would apply a little bit of that, and I would use my fingers for the highlighter to blend it out, ideally with the cream ones anyways, or with the liquid. And also it's always nice to apply it somewhere on the sides of the nose, literally where your bridge of the nose kind of folds. But again, if you don't want to attract any attention to the two specific areas, make sure to avoid the highlighter because this is its job. It's meant to kind of highlight and bring forward these features where you apply it. Another great area to apply it is on your Cupid's bow. So again, because the light will bounce off this place, your lip visually will look a little bit more prominent and bigger. So for powder highlighter, I think for me personally, I prefer a smaller brushes, ideally like a eye blending brushes. So this one's Inglot 6S, but you can use any smaller brush that you have. Obviously, if you use something like this, it would cover too large of an area with your highlighter. And as you can see, I have a lot of highlighter going on here together with the blush, because some blushers or powder blushes already have these nice kind of shiny particles in it that gives that illusion of the highlighter. But just for the purpose of this video, I'm going to show you how to apply the powder highlighter. So with the smaller brush, you want to pick up some product and always tap it off, and again, highest part of your cheek, you can slightly kind of brush it in. So literally by brushing that in, you're kind of melting this powder highlighter into your skin. And because I have so much going on here, I hope you can see how much more illuminating and highlighted that looks. But I also love to apply it above my brow, but not so much with the powder highlighters, I must say. I do prefer a liquid highlighters for that. Same here on the side of the nose and maybe above the cupid's bow. And just like that, we have applied our liquid products on one side and our powder products on the other side. Now, if you are on a normal to drier skin and you feel like the liquid products sit nicely throughout the day, you can leave it as it is. But if you are someone a little bit oilier skin, it's a good idea to set it with powder product. And again, this technique could be used if you want more intense bronzer and blusher and highlighter. So what I mean is that I know it's tacky and I know it's not set. So it means if I would wear a mask or if I'm on my phone, it might transfer and move or maybe disappear throughout the day. But again, this is not the case for everyone. Some people get away with wearing creams like that, which are not set. And I sometimes do that as well. I love how it looks. I don't mind if it's disappearing or absorbing a little bit, rather than having full on kind of powdery look. But sometimes when I want that longevity of the liquid products, I would use the same brush, the same powder products, just to slightly set what I did here. So I would just go over a little bit with the powder products over the bronzer. Not so much with the blusher, because I feel this place here, unless I'm wearing mask, but this place doesn't really move anywhere. It's, I think, this side here that if I'm kind of touching my face or I'm on the phone, whatever, it kind of wipes off. So I think bronzer would be the best thing to set if you want that longevity. I also love how blusher looks when it's not set. It's dewy, it's nice, it doesn't look powdery. But if it's the case that you have to set it, remember that if you have liquid products underneath and you set it with powder products, everything will look more intense, because you have kind of like a double of everything. So you have liquid underneath and then you have that powder on top. But again, if you use very minimal, small quantities, you can definitely do that. You can just set your liquid products. And I prefer to use liquid highlighters and don't even set it with anything. Just keep them nice and dewy and glowy looking. There's always an exception in makeup, because there's no strict rules. So even if you use your powder products first and you want to apply that cream blusher on top, you can absolutely do so. Just make sure you do a dabbing motion using your finger or your sponge and be very careful not to move that powder underneath. You can absolutely do the same thing with the highlighter. Even though if you have your face set with powders, you can use your highlighter on top, but again, be extra careful not to move the product underneath. So literally just very, very gently, very small amounts, preferably with fingers, because these are the best to apply liquids on top. And the last tip that I can give you, how to secure the whole thing, what you did, is the setting spray or finishing spray. So a good setting spray that would really set your liquid products in place, as well as if you're using powder products, it would set it in place, but at the same time, it would take away that powdery look. So it's always good to even start with the setting spray or finishing spray, and also to finish with it. Let it dry and then you're good to go. So I hope it's been helpful, and I hope you learned something and understood the difference between applying liquid makeup products versus powder makeup products. Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you enjoyed this type of video, make sure to press the thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you all next week. Bye.